Good morning to you. One of my favorite entrepreneurs is the one I wrote about in the Entrepreneur Roller Coaster under the Trust Your Gut category. He's the guy who had the highfalutin Wall Street dream job and left it all on a hunch, even before he collected his cush annual bonus, against the advice of his boss and the people around him. Even though he had a wife and family to support and a group of peers who knew him as the highfalutin Wall Street guy, he was going to bet it all for some crazy little internet startup idea. Scary, right? How'd it work out? Well, today I probably received something I bought from him nearly every day. And every day it feels like Christmas every time. Who's this wild and crazy guy? Of course, I'm talking about Jeff Bezos, founder and CEO of Amazon. You know the Jeff Bezos of today, one of the richest people in the world, worth over $40 billion on last account. And besides us naming him Success Magazine's Achiever of the Year, he was also named Person of the Year by Time Magazine and Business Person of the Year by Fortune. Sounds like a success story, right? Actually, it is a story about failure. Lots of it, and very, very expensive failure. Bezos has made more mistakes than many of us will make in a lifetime. At minimum, he's lost more money than we or our companies will ever make, adding up to over $1 billion. Good morning to you. One of my favorite entrepreneurs is the one I wrote about in the Entrepreneur Roller Coaster under the Trust Your Gut category. He's the guy who had the highfalutin Wall Street dream job and left it all on a hunch, even before he collected his cush annual bonus, against the advice of his boss and the people around him. Even though he had a wife and family to support and a group of peers who knew him as the highfalutin Wall Street guy, he was going to bet it all for some crazy little internet startup idea. Scary, right? How'd it work out? Well, today I probably received something I bought from him nearly every day. And every day it feels like Christmas every time. Who's this wild and crazy guy? Of course, I'm talking about Jeff Bezos, founder and CEO of Amazon. You know the Jeff Bezos of today, one of the richest people in the world, worth over $40 billion on last account. And besides us naming him Success Magazine's Achiever of the Year, he was also named Person of the Year by Time Magazine and Business Person of the Year by Fortune. Sounds like a success story, right? Actually, it is a story about failure. Lots of it, and very, very expensive failure. Bezos has made more mistakes than many of us will make in a lifetime. At minimum, he's lost more money than we or our companies will ever make, adding up to over $1 billion, what he and his investors characterized as bad choices. In 1998, the fledgling Amazon sold books, music, and movies, and quickly became an online leader in those categories. The company attracted significant venture capital, and Bezos had dreams of turning Amazon into the everything store. So after considerable market research, he decided to branch off into the toy market. But toys were very different from Amazon's previous offerings. Because there were no major distributors, Amazon had to actually buy the toys from various manufacturers, store them in inventory, and hope that they sold. This went against Amazon's core business model, but Bezos could not be dissuaded. Bezos insisted on spending $120 million to buy toys against the advice of every Amazon executive, even the head of the toy department. Bezos wouldn't budge. He said, "Even if I have to, I will drive to the landfill myself if it fails and throw all the toys into the dump." That comment proved to be clairvoyant because after Christmas, there was $50 million in toys left over that had to be given away or disposed of. In the same year, Bezos also started Amazon Auctions, which he felt could overtake eBay. He spent $175 million acquiring the payment company Accept.com to facilitate transactions between buyers and sellers. But it was a bigger failure than toys for Amazon. So we're at 50 million plus 175 million so far. How about we double our rate of failure? What do you say? 1998, he also purchased a site company and a comparison company for $170 million. It had to be disbanded in a matter of months. Poof, another $170 million gone. Come on, let's speed this thing up. Bezos has big goals. We gotta fail faster. So he went on a huge shopping spree in 1998 and 99, buying companies including a movie site, imbd.com, a social networking company, Planet All, a data company, Alexa, British and a German bookstore. He also invested heavily in drugstore.com, pets.com, gear.com, wineshopper.com, greenlight.com, and homegrocer.com. As Bezos said in his own words, almost all of them went down in flames. Here's also what he said. We will make bold bets rather than timid investment decisions where we see a significant probability of a game-changing market leadership position. Some of these investments will pay off, others will not, and we will have learned another valuable lesson in either case. He also said, if you never want to be criticized, for goodness sakes, don't do anything new. Here's a summation of what Jeff Bezos says about success and about innovation. The way I think about it, if you want to invent, if you want to do any innovation, anything new, you're going to have failures because you need to experiment. By the very definition of experiment, most are not going to work out. But the few that do, more than compensate for the rest. I think the amount of useful invention you do is directly proportional to the number of experiments you can run per week, per month, per year. So yes, Jeff Bezos has made a number of bad and embarrassing investments, which is true of all great achievers. At the same time, he's had some super duper home runs like Zappos, Shopbop, diapers.com, and his personal portfolio includes Google, Airbnb, Uber. And you can see that over time, Bezos' wins have far more than paid for his losses. While he has had many more failures than successes, his successes paid for the failures, and the net return was gargantuan. Well, as you've already heard, a personal net effect of $40 billion and the second largest e-commerce company on God's green earth. You see, that is the big lesson here. It takes the failures to get you to the successes. And if you adopt this mindset that failures are only part of the process of learning, iterating, and discovering and navigating yourself to the successes, without the transactions of failures, you cannot get yourself to the net effect of success. Your mindset now has to know that in the end, through all the seemingly endless, embarrassing, and painful in-the-moment failures, it only takes one or two successes to make up for and pay for. Successes paid for the failures includes Google, Airbnb, Uber, and you can see that over time, Bezos wins. Have far more than paid for his losses. While he has had many more failures than successes, his successes paid for the failures, and the net return was gargantuan. Well, as you've already heard, a personal net effect of $40 billion and the second largest e-commerce company on God's green earth. You see, that is the big lesson here. It takes the failures to get you to the successes. And if you adopt this mindset that failures are only part of the process of learning, iterating, and discovering and navigating yourself to the successes, without the transactions of failures, you cannot get yourself to the net effect of success. Your mindset now has to know that in the end, through all the seemingly endless, embarrassing, and painful in-the-moment failures, it only takes one or two successes to make up for and pay for all the failures and have your net result be, well, massive success. One of my other mentors, Paul J. Meyer, taught me this principle as well by his own example. He said, and he's one that I had sold one of my companies to, and then I actually went to work for him to do a turnaround on another company that he had. I asked him, I said, of all the companies that you've started, which were over 200 in total, how many of them ended up being successful? He said, 10%. 90% of them failed. But those 10% were really, really successful. I could attest to it as Paul was incredibly wealthy and his family continues to be long after his passing. That always stuck with me. 90% of everything you try can fail and the 10% can make you wealthy. The key therein lies to get to the 10%, you have to make that 10% really big and you have to fail faster. Hey, so we talked about some key business strategies today, and I remember being at the start of my entrepreneurial journey. Man, oh man, was I afraid and nervous, and I had no clue to what I was doing. As a result, I did most everything mostly wrong, and that meant it cost me a lot. It cost me in time and money and relationships and precious periods of my life. Looking back now, I know that it didn't have to be that way. I could have sought out the training and the guidance that would have prevented so many errors that I made, and it would have helped accelerate my success. That is the resource that I can be for you. I took everything that I learned through my wild roller coaster ride as an entrepreneur, plus the insights that I picked up by interviewing the greatest business leaders of our time, and I put it together in this book. And I want to just give it to you, give you this book as a gift. A mentor of mine once told me, when you make it to the top floor, be sure to send the elevator back down to help others up. And that's what I'm doing here. You could just go to darrenhardybook.com to get your copy. I'll buy the book. You just cover the cost of shipping for me to get it to you. And I hope that it helps.